Hi, my name is Tim Kroger and I'm part of the Gunt sales team. Today I'm going to show you one of my favorite units, the CE650 biodiesel plant. The purpose of the CE650 is to demonstrate the production of biodiesel on a laboratory scale. Production of biodiesel with the help of catalysts is called transesterification. Transesterification is basically the restructuring of the molecule chains of the product. On the bottom of the units, we have the four stainless steel tanks for the materials, and from left to right, they are the tank for the catalyst, and that is methanol and potassium hydroxide. Then the large tank for the vegetable oil, small tank again for the byproduct of the process, and then finally the large tank for the biodiesel. As you can see, the CE650 comes in two separate parts. These parts are interconnected with hoses to transfer the product from one part to the other. The product is what we call the biodiesel along its various stages in the process. They're also connected electrically to transfer process and control data. Here at the front, we've got quite a battery of pumps, 12 in total actually, and they are peristaltic pumps, typical in the chemical engineering field. At the back of the tank for the catalyst, we have a stirrer to maintain a homogeneous, well-defined ratio between the methanol and the potassium hydroxide. For the first part of the process, we pump the catalysts and the vegetable oil into a reactor where they are kept at approximately 60 degrees Celsius for a predefined amount of time. The reactor has a stirrer to ensure that the mixture is homogeneous, and it also has an intelligent liquid level sensor with a display. From there, we transfer the product into the phase separator, where most of the byproducts of the process settle on the bottom and the now biodiesel-rich products at the top. We have an adjustable takeoff from where we transfer the product into the second part of the process. The reactor and separator setup is duplicated on the unit, and this enables you to run the process as a two-stage esterification for a higher grade biodiesel as the end product. The byproducts are transferred directly into the byproduct storage tank for later disposal. The biodiesel-rich product is now transferred to the other side into a methanol evaporator. Here we get rid of most of the methanol by a process of electrically controlled evaporation. The methanol is, with the help of heat exchangers, recovered and stored in the methanol recovery tank. The product is transferred to a purifier where we eliminate most of the remaining byproducts with the help of water and nitrogen. The nitrogen bubbles up from the bottom and is initially stored in a large industrial nitrogen bubble which is strapped to the right-hand side of the frame. From here we come to the brains of the operation, and that is the touchscreen PLC. From here we control the process, lead the students in an interactive way through the experiment, and display all control and process parameters on the P&ID, the process and instrumentation diagram, which is displayed on the touchscreen. That in a nutshell was the Gunt CE650 biodiesel plant. For more information, make sure to visit our homepage or contact us directly with your question. Until next time,